Hey friends, kinsmen and kinswomen, this is Tatay Ramboy, your bioorganic farmer, welcoming you to Bioorganic Series. Today we will discuss or talk about this beautiful, aromatic, and my favorite fruit or vegetable. This is luffa. Okay. Spelled out as L-U-F-F-A or L-O-O-F-A-H, okay, whichever you prefer. Okay, so its scientific name is Luffa aegyptica or Luffa cylindrica. This kind is smooth ang yung surface. Okay. There is another type of luffa that is not smooth. Naa siya yung protrude nga hait, no? So ridged siyang luffa. Okay, but this one is an Egyptian luffa. It's smooth and it's very aromatic. Smells good, especially sa Utan Bisaya, sa Lauoy, or sa Laswa in Ilonggo. Okay? So it's very easy to plant the luffa, actually. Mura siya ridge, hait nga portion. So kaning iyahang murag na line dere, naa siya ga protrude nga hait, no? So ridge siya nga luffa. Okay, but this one is an Egyptian luffa. It's smooth and it's very aromatic. Smells good, especially sa Utan Bisaya, sa Lauoy, or sa Laswa in Ilonggo. Okay, once this fruit fully matures, of course you will have your seeds, no? Because this is a seed pod, the whole thing, and inside is a sponge, no? And once this fully matures, the seed also will dry up and it will turn into black, no? Flat ang iyahang seeds nga black, oblong iyahang shape, small, very small. I think it's smaller than my pinky nail. And ang iyahang sponge is used usually sa mga sa bathroom or sa kitchen as a scrubbing sponge, no? Pwede sa body, sa lawas, or pwede po sa tiles sa kitchen. Okay, it's being actually processed and used in our kitchen or bathrooms. This is how the seed looks like. It's oblong and it's black and it's flat. And that closer look, so it's flat and it's oblong. It's just as big as my smaller than my pinky nail. Okay, so I got this from a dried fruit or fully matured fruit, luffa fruit. It's just very easy to grow or plant luffa. You just take out 3 to 4 seeds and then bury it on the ground. So if you have if you want it planted on the ground directly, that's usually my way of growing it directly on the ground. So you just dig on the ground about 1 inch from the surface, and then you place the seed about 2 inches apart, like that. So I make a triangle here, so one here and the other one is here and the other one is here. So bakit tatlo yung binaon natin sa lupa? Ang purpose niyan is to make sure that we will have a sprout or seedling later on after a few days. Kasi kung isa lang yung ilagay natin, baka hindi siya mabuting seed at tapos hindi mag-sprout. So sayang yung oras. Okay? So that's the purpose why we, you know, bury 3 or 4. Or even 5, no? And the purpose why we distance the pagbaon ng seed is para kung tumubo sila lahat, then we can transplant the other. Mag-retain lang tayo ng isang puno para sa in that particular area. Okay na yan. Like this one. So isa mag-isa lang ito, but this is a transplanted seedling from where I saw the seed, no? I saw the seed. So marami ito sila, parang mga anim yata or pito, something like that. And then I transplanted, no? Some of them. So meron dito, tapos meron din doon. Okay? So galing sa bahay ito. And then it's already actually climbing up the mahogany tree. Okay, yung mahogany tree natin is already pruned. Kinuha na natin yung mga main branches niya, malalaking branches, para yung lupa, vines, yung vines na hindi masyadong mataas. Mahirapan tayo mag-harvest kung sobrang taas ng vine. Okay, so I just want, you know, want her to, you know, be hanging on that from that small branches overhead, no? Para kung maghang na yung mga fruits niya, ay very easy na to harvest, no? Okay, so this is about 2 weeks or going 3 weeks, and we're expecting that after 2 months we will already have fruits and vegetables. After a month, when the vine starts to climb already overhead, it will create flowers, no? This is a male flower, and then I don't know if we can find a female flower. Actually, this comes from a female flower, so we will look for a female flower, a young one, so I can show it to you. This one. So this is a shoot already. So it's not the main vine. So it's already a shoot, no, an offshoot from the main vine. So ito yung female flower. So meron siyang fruit dito sa puno niya, at tapos may sa tip niya is the flower. So another example of that is here. So this is the fruit part, or the seed pod. That's the seed pod part. And this is the flower. Okay, so I think that's clear on the screen. So that is a young fruit or seed pod of lupa. Okay, cylindrica. So as it goes wild overhead, dadami rin yung mga bunga niya. Okay, so and it's always good for fruits of this vine to be hung. So dapat mahang siya sa, in this case, sa loob ng chicken run natin, nakahang yung mga bunga. So like that. So meron pa dito outside the structure. So ito, it's still very young. Okay, so kulang pa ito ng edad, kulang pa ng few days, siguro mga 3 days or 2, we can already harvest the vegetables. So meron pa doon sa loob, no? Nakahang yun. Once it already starts to flower and provide fruits, ito hindi nahihinto. It continuously, it will bear fruit. What's good about this vine or vegetable is that it doesn't need a lot of, you know, effort and skill, and even, you know, a lot of time. So it doesn't take a lot of your time. Once you have buried the seed and it already sprouts and starts to climb up, then that's it. What you have to do is just water them, no? Water it every day. Once a day, it's okay. So again, this is Tatay Ramboy. Hoping that you have learned something from this series on lupa cylindrica. Good day. Keep safe, everyone. See you soon. Au revoir.